So what courses do you need to take and in what order to become an expert programmer? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And the question is, what courses or training do you need to undertake to become an expert in a particular programming language? Now, I'm going to try and keep this video fairly generic so that it covers a lot of different programming languages. But it is important to realize that learning programming is a journey and it doesn't necessarily end at any specific point. Now, the reason for that is that technology is constantly changing, and as you get more into your training and complete training and become more experienced, you'll find there's more that you actually need to know. There's an old saying out there that goes something along the lines of, the more that you learn, the more that you realize of things or extra things that you still need to learn. So in other words, as you understand or your understanding increases, you realize that, there's a lot more that I need to learn here. And that is the case with programming. So it doesn't really ever get to a stage where you finish this particular course and that's it, you're now an expert programmer and you never need to undergo training again. You should really look at training as something you're going to be doing throughout your career, but obviously the content and the type of training will change as your career progresses, because you'll get more experience and learn basically more about programming. But in general, if you're starting out, you'd probably start with a basic programming language course, something that teaches you the basic syntax. As an example, if you're learning Java, I'll use that analogy here for my courses, but again, this will apply equally to any programming language. You'd start with something maybe like my Java Crash Course or my Java Masterclass. Now, both of those are designed to take someone who's got little to no programming experience and to give them a good solid overview or foundation of, in this case, Java or programming skills in general. So once you've finished that course, you won't be an expert programmer for the reasons I've outlined earlier. You'll then need to start trying to think about what you want to do next. Now, at this point, you could do something like move into Android app development. You could do something like Spring or Java Enterprise Edition, etc. But that's more going to a specific type or area of programming. What I would also suggest you look at is something like enhancing your skills in algorithms, design patterns, data structures, those sorts of fundamental things that will make you a more productive and better programmer. Now, I've got a data structures and algorithms course for Java as an example. I've also got a Java design patterns course. Now, that will give you the general skills that you can apply to different frameworks and different areas of programming, as in the examples that I talked about, Android app development and Java Enterprise Edition. So I think a good foundation would be those courses that I've outlined to move into other roles. But look, that's not essential, and it certainly wouldn't end there. You might then start looking at intermediate and advanced level training or specific framework training, depending on what you're wanting to learn. You know, for example, if you decide to focus on Java Enterprise Edition, that's your area of programming, then you start looking at perhaps programming courses or training related to that technology. So hopefully that gives you a bit of a brief overview. There is no really one way. There's not one set of courses that applies to all areas of programming. But in general, start with basic courses, then try and look at your algorithms, data structures, design patterns, those sorts of things to build fundamental programming skills that can be applied to any area of programming. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.